Hey Aiden, quick question for you. What are the differences between the Unity client, the web client, and the thick client for an end user in OnBase?
It's a bit of a big question, but I've got something thrown together that I think can answer your question. Let me share my screen. The first client we're going to take a look at is the OnBase client, also known as the thick client. You're greeted with a very classic look, and that's because the focus of this client is the core functionality of OnBase. It's not focused on user customization, and for that reason, it has low overhead and should be used to process heavy workloads and complex jobs. There are administrative controls available. However, a lot of the controls are nested underneath other controls. This client also requires a direct ODBC connection, which is unique. I'm going to perform a quick document retrieval so that I can show you some of what I mean when I say it has low overhead. I'm going to do an unrestricted query and retrieve some PDFs. As you see, it was very quick in its results, and it brought open a very plain text result window. Opening the document that I searched for brings up a clear PDF, but again, it's in a mostly text-based and very basic graphical user interface windows. The next client I want to look at is the Unity client. Almost immediately, you can tell that this differs greatly from the thick client, and that's because the Unity client has a large focus on how it's dynamic and customizable to the user. This homepage that you land on is fully user configurable, as is the personal page, which is great for adding shortcuts to forms, documents, workflow queues, dashboards, custom queries, retrievals, and pretty much any other element that you can access in the Unity client. If you don't want to set up a personal page, you can instead add them to your favorites and they'll show up there instead. A lot of your core function is available in the ribbon, and you don't have to do much searching for additional settings. Another huge perk to the Unity client is its ability to access Unity forms. The thick client does not have the ability to access Unity forms, although it can access the essential data and keywords that come from Unity forms. Another perk of the Unity client is reporting dashboards, which can be configured to do things like check the databases for data and then visualize them and show them in an appealing way. These elements can all be added to your personal page, your homepage, or your favorites as well. There are also lots of sorting options for both retrieval and for doing custom queries, which are pre-configurable. I'll perform a quick retrieval on a PDF. As you see this list, it's much cleaner and less of a text-based graphical user interface than the thick client. And if I open up one of the documents, it opens in its own interface with lots of options at the top, unlike it did in the thick client. The next client we're going to look at is the web client. The web client is the most accessible and lightweight client available. All that's needed to access the web client is an OnBase login and a web browser. This is great for users who need to perform lots of document retrieval, as you can tell by the default splash screen, which brings you directly to it. Additional functionality can be found in these options here, but you'll notice that there's not a lot of options or features available, and that's just the nature of the web client. I'll perform a quick document retrieval so you can see what that looks like. You'll notice that this initial view is more similar to the Unity client. However, if you open up a document in a new window, you're met with very little true functionality at the top of the viewer, which is more similar to the thick client. If you need to check what web client type you are running, you can do so in the Web Application Management Console. To check, open up the WAMCOM, open the web application to your web server, select the Web Client tab, and you'll see Web Client Type is listed with a dropdown. The dropdown should be set to ActiveX or HTML. This module reference guide contains a section known as the feature matrix. The feature matrix lists options and features available throughout the OnBase platforms and shows which client supports each feature. This MRG goes way more in depth than I have time to cover today, so I recommend you check it out if you need specifics for your client and your integrations.
Hit the subscribe button to stay up to date with all of our free training resources. And make sure that you reach out if you have any questions that you'd like featured in an upcoming episode of The Question Corner.